Today I am going to discuss with you my favorite swing trading strategy for options selling. In this video, I am going to share a 3-point strategy with you on how I select options, so do watch this video till the end. This is the agenda of our presentation today. We are going to discuss our objective, that is selling stock options or index options. The problem that we face in option selling, that is the increased volatility in the market. What is our solution to that problem? And finally, the strategy details, the 3-point formula that we use to sell options. We are also going to take some real world examples and some real trades to discuss with you so that you can understand clearly how we are going to execute this particular strategy. First question that pops into your mind is, why stock option selling? Let's take this particular example of Tata Power. The time frame here is 3 hours, and my analysis say that this particular stock has topped out here, okay? And I want to sell a 415 call of 26th March. Now this option is priced at 6.50 rupees and the margin required is 2,11,000. That is roughly 23,000 rupees and return is 10% on deployed capital. So coming back to the question, why stock option selling? Because the returns are very high, okay, if done right. Now what are the problems that we face? The first problem that we face is, if we are selling naked options, it entails an unlimited risk, okay? But that thing can be solved when we are doing spreads. We can do a credit spread like bull put spread or a bear call spread. Second thing is volatility. What I mean by volatility is that if you're selling an option for 10 rupees, you will see that due to the volatility, even when your direction is right, there are price fluctuations, which causes that particular price to go from 10 to 20 to 30 and suddenly it goes to zero as it approaches expiry. So how to tackle that volatility? And then is increased stop loss hunting. So what just happened in the second point, volatility, where an option is going from 10 rupees to 15 rupees or 20 rupees, that is just stop loss hunting that is happening before expiry. This is something of a problem that we face in option selling. So let me share a real world example with you. This right in front of you is a trade of Tata Power that I did last month. Okay, I sold an option for 7 rupees, as you can see, for a call of 380. Uske baad maine Tata Power ki 370 ki put sell ki, then I was selling call of 420, 400, 430. All this was to save my position from making loss. You can see that I made a profit of 23,000, but for that 23,000, whereas my initial capital invested should have been 2,11,000, I ended up using 10 lakh and unnecessary adjustments. So just selling does not work in this particular market. We need systematic method to sell options, and that is what this presentation is about. So before we move towards the solution of the problem, what are the considerations before us? The first is that options can only be sold in FNO. There are roughly 180 to 200 stocks that trade in options. That means 200 stocks have call or put option which we can sell. And there is a high probability of these OTM options expiring worthless. I mean, there is a 70% probability that these options that are OTM, if taken with the right direction, that will go to zero. And third thing that you need to understand is that the FNO stocks are more mean reversing. What I mean by that is that these are large cap companies. ये इंडिया की कुछ सबसे बड़ी कंपनीज हैं. इफ दे ऑल स्टार्ट ट्रेंडिंग एट द सेम टाइम, निफ्टी इंडेक्स विच इज करंटली एट 22,000, इट माइट रीच टू 35,000 वेरी फास्ट. सो दीज कंपनीज डोंट ट्रेंड दैट फास्ट, दे आर मीन रिवर्टिंग बाय नेचर. सो हियर 70-30 रूल कम्स इन टू प्ले. वट दैट मीन्स इज दैट द स्टॉक मार्केट इज ट्रेंडिंग 30% ऑफ द टाइम एंड रेस्ट 70% ऑफ द टाइम मार्केट इज साइडवेज. That is why this mean reversing nature of market can be exploited to spot trend reversals. We are assuming that if the market is going up, it will eventually come down by the mean reversing nature of the stocks. So let's move to strategy now. For this strategy to work of spotting trend reversals, we are going to use RSI. RSI ke 4 components hote hain. The first one is the oversold condition, which is below 30. You can see here. And second component is overbought condition, which is above 70, and third is sideways, which is between 40 and 60. The fourth component is the EMA that I have plotted on RSI of 20 length, which I use to just remove the noise from the RSI chart. Okay, as you can see that this particular RSI is very erratic here. Okay, So it is going up, going down. It is very difficult to spot a trend out of it. So what I have done is I have plotted an EMA on it so that when RSI is above EMA, it is bullish. When RSI is below EMA, it is bearish. Okay?
अगर आप अभी तक ये वीडियो देख रहे हो देन आई एज्यूम जो भी कंटेंट हम आप लोगों के लिए लेके आ रहे हैं यू आर लाइकिंग इट. आगे भी हमने बहुत ज़्यादा सारा कंटेंट प्लान करके रखा हुआ. इफ यू लाइक द एफर्ट जस्ट हिट दैट लाइक बटन एंड सब्सक्राइब द चैनल. दैट इज द लीस्ट यू कैन डू टू सपोर्ट अवर एफर्ट्स.
सो व्हाट डू यू अंडरस्टैंड बाय रिलेटिव स्ट्रेंथ इंडेक्स? इट मीन्स दैट व्हेन द प्राइस इज गोइंग अप RSI विल बी गोइंग अप. सो इन दिस एग्जाम्पल इफ यू कैन सी this is the point where the price made a low and RSI is also making a low at this particular point. When price made a higher low, even RSI made a higher low. Okay? Again, price made a higher low and RSI made a higher low. So as price is moving, the same way RSI is moving. This is the general definition of RSI, relative strength index. But you have to understand the anatomy of overbought and oversold. This right here in front of you is a chart of Coal India. And as you can see, from September till December, RSI has been in the overbought condition and then also the price is going up. And it doesn't stop here. Even when RSI is above the 60 level, it has been 8 months from September till March, price is still going up. Why I'm telling you this is because overbought and oversold conditions are not enough to buy a stock or to sell a stock. A stock can remain in an overbought condition for months, and same is the case with sell side also. It can remain in an oversold zone for a long time, and if you're just buying and selling based on that, you're going to make losses. So to get accurate signals out of RSI, we use a concept called divergence. What do you mean by divergence? Divergence means that when the price is going up, this is price, if RSI is going down at that particular time, it is called divergence. Why divergence? Because in the normal course, they move in tandem with each other. But now they have diverged their path. So if one is going up, the other is coming down, or price is coming down but the RSI is moving up. So that is divergence. So when price is making higher highs but RSI is making lower highs, that is divergence. Inversely, when the price is making lower lows but RSI is making higher lows, that is also divergence. How do we spot it? Let's move ahead and see. In this chart right here, you can see that as and when price is going up, RSI is also going up. But there is a divergence here. At this point, price is making higher highs and RSI is making lower highs. So this is a divergence because price is going up like this, RSI is going down like this. Another thing that you need to remember while spotting the divergence is ki agar aap yahan pe highs ko match karke higher highs ki ek trend line upar ki taraf ko bana rahe ho, RSI ke upar bhi ye aapko highs ke upar hi plot karni hai. Let's look at a bullish example also. In this example of Larsen and Toubro, there is a bullish divergence. If you can see, price is making lower lows here and RSI is making higher lows here. So again, price is coming down but RSI is going up. That is a divergence. And see, here I'm matching the lows on price and I'm matching the lows on RSI. So this is what you have to keep in mind. When you're looking for a bearish divergence, you have to match the highs. When you are looking for a bullish divergence, you have to match the lows. Now let's look at the trading setup. So what I do is I look for the divergence. I look for the break of a price on the trend line. Based upon that, I sell an out of the money option. Now the question that may arise in your mind that how do I select a strike price? In the example of Tata Power, I took 415 call strike to sell. At that point of time, I was getting a return of 10% on Tata Power 415 call strike. Based upon your risk assessment, you can decide to sell a call strike of 430 also, where you might be getting a premium of let's say 4 rupees, but that will still be a return of 5% to 6%. So that is how you can select a strike. And if you think that naked call option selling is not for you because it entails an unlimited risk, What you can do is, you can do a bear call spread or a bull put spread based upon the signal that you are getting. That way, you will not have an overnight naked position, you will be hedged. And then what is the stop loss for the sold option price? That is 70%. So if I am selling an option for rupees 10, my stop loss will be 17 rupees. At 17 rupees, I will just exit my position. And what is my target? My target is zero, and you can create an option spread. And understand one thing, I am using this method specifically for stock option selling. I don't use it on equity, I don't use it on futures, because the losses can be big. We have to play where probability of our winning is high. That is why we are doing this particular analysis, where with the help of trend reversals, we are catching the sweet spot from where if we sell options, it has high probability of going zero. And by fundamentals also of the options, OTM options tend to go zero more often than ATM or ITM options. This is the chart of Hindustan Petro. Okay, you can see that the price is moving up and it is in a considerable bullish trend, but there is an RSI divergence on this particular chart. Price is making higher highs, RSI is making lower highs. This is a divergence. So what is our entry price? Our entry is when price breaks this particular trend line, that is our entry. This is one example. Let's look at Hind Copper. In Hind Copper example, price is making higher highs, RSI is making lower highs, and we can see that there is a divergence here, and break of this particular trend line is our entry for a selling call or a short entry. Look at the example of Hero Motor Co. This here is higher highs, and on RSI we have a lower high formation followed by a trend line break. This is our short entry. And another bullish example of Nestle Industry. You can see that the price is making lower lows, and RSI is making higher lows. It is a divergence. This particular point is our entry. Now let's look at the example of ITC. During the bull run, everybody was asking me ki hame ITC buy karna chahiye, ITC buy karna chahiye. Yahan pe mujhse logon ne pucha buy karne ke liye, yahan pe mujhse buy karne ke liye pucha. But when price reached this particular point, maine sabko mana kar diya ki ITC ko buy mat karna. My reasons were very simple. ITC was making higher highs, and on RSI I was spotting a divergence. So maine bahut clearly bola tha ki once this ट्रेंड लाइन इज ब्रोकन दिस स्टॉक कैन गो डाउन. और मैंने ये अपना स्टैंस बार बार रीट्रेट किया था कोई अप्रॉक्सीमेटली 1 month तक. कई लोगों ने उसके बावजूद उसको बाय किया एंड दे मेड लॉसेज आउट ऑफ इट, वेयर एज दिस वॉज टाइम टू गो बेरिश ऑन दिस पर्टिकुलर स्टॉक. दिस इज हाउ यू कैन यूज डाइवर्जेंस ऑन RSI टू स्पॉट ट्रेंड रिवर्सल्स एंड सेल ऑप्शंस बेस्ड ऑन दैट. नाउ यहाँ पे मैंने आपको जो भी चार्ट शो किए हैं, दीज आर हिस्टोरिकल चार्ट्स. यू विल से वेदर वी कैन ट्रेड इन रियल बेस्ड अपॉन दिस. येस वी कैन. आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर जस्ट वन ट्रेड विद यू विच आई टुक ऑन भेल, सो दैट यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड दैट इट इज रियली पॉसिबल टू टेक ट्रेड्स थ्रू RSI डाइवर्जेंस. नाउ आई एम शोइंग यू द चार्ट ऑफ भारत हैवी इलेक्ट्रिकल लिमिटेड. इट इज़ अ 2 hour चार्ट. ऑन 12 फरवरी आई स्पॉटेड अ डाइवर्जेंस. यू कैन सी कि प्राइस के ऊपर यहाँ पे हायर हाइज बन रही है, बट RSI के ऊपर लोअर हाइज क्रिएट हो रही है. एंड इफ वी मेक अ ट्रेंड लाइन हेयर, इस सर्कल के पास हमें ट्रेंड लाइन ब्रेक मिल रहा था, एंड दैट इज़ वाई आई सोल्ड अ 240 कॉल एंड अ 260 कॉल. उसको हेज करने के लिए मैंने नेक्स्ट मंथ की 250 की कॉल बाय कर ली. यू कैन सी मार्जिन रिक्वायर्ड फॉर दिस ट्रेड वॉज वेरी लेस, whereas the return I am getting on this trade right now is very high. This is how you can use RSI plus divergence to catch trend reversals on stock option selling or index option selling. The time frame, it has to be 2 hour or 3 hour charts. And today also I have created another bearish trade on BPCL. As you can see, price is making higher highs here, RSI is making lower highs, and there is a clear trend line break at this particular point. Price when made this particular red candle, I sold a 680 call, 6 rupees ke upar, and that is an easy again 7 to 8% return. So this is all about trading reversals through RSI. If you have any queries about it, put it in the comments and we will surely answer them.